Online multiplayer chat is pretty much a hive of scum and villainy. We all know not to go there. It is full of the worst people. They're going to be awful and they're going to ruin your experience. But it seems that as of late, in more recent games, this is starting to fizzle out a little bit. Sometimes the chat is more private or it's opt-in, or sometimes it's just not there at all if you've played the Destiny Alpha or Beta. And is this a good thing or maybe a bad thing?
I think this is sort of this natural maturation process of how chat is online, because when we first were developing commercial uses of the internet, everyone was going to the chat rooms, you know, like, oh my God, I'm talking to 30 strangers.
I want to connect.
Like, we're going to connect. And then,
but then,
after a few years, we started pulling back, like, maybe I'll just have these people. Maybe I only want my own friends list. Maybe I only want, and then we started using the block features. And social media, while we're putting certain things out there, we're also becoming, a lot of us, much more careful about who do we actually talk to, who do we actually let have access to us.
You don't know. The good and bad.
Yeah, we saw the power and then we got mature about it and said, wait, we actually don't care about speaking to 50 strangers. We want to speak to these 10 people we know and maybe let their friends in on the fun. And that's kind of, I think, what's happening here. I think it makes sense, and I don't think anything's really lost from it. I mean, if you are a social butterfly, there are still options to find other people online.
Well, as I started to allude to, in Titanfall, there's private chat. In Destiny, there's no chat. You're able to use the D-pad to punch in commands. But I don't know. Dancing is cool, but I don't know how that communicates to other people. Because you want to say, like, hey, go there. Hey, there's danger. I'm on my way. That kind of thing, at least. So maybe we are losing a little bit. Though I have to be honest, when I jump into online multiplayer, the first thing I do is pause, then I mute everybody who's not someone I know.
Yeah, and I do think there should be some chat feature, like, of some sort, just for you and your friends. Like, that's fun, you know, even if you're not talking about the game directly. It's just fun to shoot the crap about stories or movies you just saw while you're hunting down an alien or trying to be stealthy. I mean, that's really fun. So I wouldn't do away with it entirely.
Everybody makes their own experience.
Yeah.
So, like, the reason that people don't like the open world chat and that everybody can hear what you're saying or typing or whatnot is because there's a lot of people out there that are assholes.
Yeah.
Most of them are kids.
That comes with that level of anonymity that a game provides you.
Sure.
Your name is not there, your face is not there, your address is not there. It's just an avatar or a username.
There's no consequence.
Yeah.
As far as you see.
Right, right. Mm. And because people are assholes.
Not that there are sometimes consequences, but they're putting themselves in
the
view.
I just don't feel that, you know, the public chat or the global chat adds much to my experience. I don't need to hear a 14-year-old go in their shitty mic like, gay! That doesn't help anything. It makes me hate the game and want to avoid the multiplayer.
That said, there was something so magical about vanilla WoW and Baron's chat. And going there where all the new players were all congregating, trying to figure the game out, and just that global chat that existed in that area was just so unlike any other form of communication on the planet. And it was funny, it was rude, it was irreverent, it was crazy. There were trolls and kids and adults all living together in the same microcosm of humanity. And it was, I wouldn't trade that. The game would not be as memorable to me without that. Mm-hmm. But now we're seeing that sometimes that experience ruins a game for a person.
Especially if you're new to it or you don't know anyone.
Right, absolutely.
Or if you have thin skin or if you,
it's been really bad.
Even if you have thick skin, like, I don't particularly care what people online think about me, but I don't want to deal with it either. I've got crap to do. It gets annoying.
It's at least annoying when people are like that. Like, you know, I get harassed all the time. I'm a woman on the internet. But it's just it doesn't really hurt me at this point. It's just like, I don't need this. I don't need this shit. I could cut it out and I'd be fine.
So for a lot of games, it is a good idea to turn that, maybe not remove it altogether, but turn it off by default.
Yeah, that's actually what Riot did. They turned off their public chat by default. You still have access to it, but
you
do
want
have
that, experience,
that one
dive
extra
right
step
in
to go get it. So you have to opt in. You have to say, I want this, which I think is a good solution.
It makes it so that your first experience when you turn the game on is not awful yelling, loud noises, and racism.
I hate you and the bands that you like!
Yeah. So, I mean, you have to opt into that awful, yelling, hate-filled racism ranting.
If you dig that, then go.
If that's what you're into.
Have at it, Haas. All right. What do you think of the changes that have been going on in more modern games with public and global chat being minimized, if not obliterated? Or do we actually need that level of communication? Let us know what you think below in the comments, and please be sure to subscribe.